Okay. Good evening, everyone. Good evening to Milford and Pike County. I want to thank a few special people who are here. Renee, who is a Pike County committee woman, thank you so much for coming. Ed Gregard, thank you so much for coming. Mr. Strube, the mayor of Milford, the mighty mayor of Milford, thank you for hosting me and allowing me to have my fundraiser here. Mr. Jay Tucker, president of Pike County Democrats, thank you for coming. And I want to thank each and every one of you who took the time out this evening to spend a few minutes with me and support me on this journey. This is my initial kickoff, and I'm humbly honored to have everybody here. It means a lot to me, more than you know. I'm just a simple wife, mother, and stepmother, and each one of those titles has its challenges, and it's helped propel me forward to this moment. When I witnessed the Women's March back at the beginning of 2017, it really awakened something in me. I had always had an interest in politics, but seeing such a phenomenal group of women together, unified, saying that they were not going to accept being sexually harassed or abused. They were not going to accept being paid less than men for working the same position. They were not going to upset the current administration, who really, you know, unfortunately is doing what they promised they would do. And I think we've all learned a lesson about elections. We've learned a lesson about voting and how important that is. And I'm going to briefly just talk to you about what one vote means. Now, people have said that this candidacy will be somewhat of a struggle if I do win the primary, when I win the primary. And I understand that. But I want you all to understand the importance of one vote. I think a lot about Mike Pence. Don't ask me why. But I think a lot about Mike Pence when it comes to one vote, because he's the tiebreaker in Congress, right? And we've seen him come in a few times and unfortunately break the tie and do things that we don't want. But we've also seen Republicans like John McCain with one vote stop the ACA devastation that the Republicans plan to do. There are a lot of instances where one vote can make or break. We saw in Virginia how one vote can make or break, you know, what can happen in terms of power. And I am simply asking for your one vote for me. My candidacy and my, if I am elected, would serve as your vote. I will be your voice. I will be, hopefully, maybe even a tiebreaker one day. Maybe I can come in and say, no, we're not going to do that. We're not going to allow you to do that. We're not going to let you just steamroll, you know, over the poor and middle class. You know, I want to be that voice. The most important thing that I can stress to anyone is registering to vote is so important. Being engaged in your community is so important. Coming to an event like this is just showing your engagement. You know, sharing and talking to your neighbors and friends about the importance of being involved in the process is important. My campaign has a few pillars. I do have a few important things that I want to do, and then I have a few secondary things that I like to do. But most importantly, I want to raise that minimum wage. $7.25 is for babysitters. It's not for adults that have families. The LGBT community, they don't have protections for discrimination in the workplace. That would change if I became a state representative. We're the only state that allows fracking that does not have a severance tax. And for Republicans to simply say that they're fiscally responsible and fiscally conservative, I can't tell when you're letting money walk out the door. When you have multi-state corporations doing business in this state and they're not paying sales tax, that's a problem for me. I can't escape paying my taxes. If I don't pay my taxes, they'll take my home away. You know, we're letting millions of dollars walk away that could help bring down the tax rate for small businesses and allow you guys to hire more people. I know you're a small business person. I know you can understand and appreciate that. That's what this is really about. It's about creating parity where you can, and everything won't be equal. That's not really the aim here, but it's really about having an equal footing, at least an equal start. That's what America's all about. That's why we have immigrants come here, you know. And the most important thing we can do for those immigrants is to show them respect. That's the most important thing that we can do. And we can create a process where they can realistically immigrate. Other than that, I'm just happy to be here. And again, I really appreciate you all coming out. Please share with your friends, your neighbors that do live in my district, the 189th district for Pike County. That would be Delaware, Lehman, and Porter townships. Let them know that I am ready to run and I'm moving. And I do appreciate your help and support. Thank you very much. Thank you. Good night.